$20 million to build, but the fans are thrilled with their very unique facility. Lucas Oil Stadium stands out as one of the most advanced and beautiful stadiums in the league. Taken from the 10. At the 40. They get him at the 49-yard line.
I can tell you, as a former offensive player, when you get a good kick return like that, it just takes so much of the pressure off the offense. Now, even if you get a turnover, interception, you know, whatever, you're not backed up in your own end zone. You take the field with more confidence.
They rule it incomplete. They'll face second down and 10. Ball on the 49. Passes it. Brings it in. Hayden is there on the tackle. You can tell these guys practiced that play quite a bit.
Yeah, I can remember hearing stories about old-time players in the NFL that literally they could go out in the pitch black and make throws and catches without really even seeing the ball. That's the kind of timing we're seeing today.
A gain of 6 yards on the play.
Just a simple throw and catch for a gain of six. That's just the kind of passing play this offense is built around.
Gives it off.
7 yards and a first down. The last thing in the world the defenses want to do is take people out of coverage, bring them down to help against the run, but I'm not sure they have much of a choice at this point.
The pass is away. They make the stop, but the Saints will have first and goal.
The Saints are putting together a good-looking drive here. That's their third first down.
Throws it short.
Just keeps the ball moving down the field. 6 yard gain and a little progress.
Now we'll see who can get the bigger push. He throws right. Brackett gets the pick. Well, it didn't take long to get the game's first turnover.
Oh, yeah!
It's first and 10. Escapes the pressure. Keeps looking at the 40. Makes the grab. No signal yet. We'll see what they rule. So after conferring, they're going to say he was out of bounds. It's the tailback.
And that's why you send all those guys to plug up the holes, and that time there were no holes, really, and he was lucky to get anything on the play.
Gets the pass off. Tipped away. And the pass will fall incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
And those are the kind of big third down plays you have to have on defense to get the ball back and give your team a chance on offense.
This one's going to go out of bounds at the 37. The offense will take over at the 37. First and 10. Dumps it out right. Gary Brackett makes the tackle. Henderson picks up 2 yards with that grab. Gives to the back. Mathis is there on the tackle. Third down and 7. Passes on the move. Tackle is made by Bob Sanders.
There's nothing better for a quarterback than to have a big body guy like that that can catch the football. Nice play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Gets the ball away. He's there for the catch. Marcus Colston crosses the plane. Or maybe he didn't. He did not score. First down now. They'll be looking for 6 points here. Bush gets the carry. The Saints get the first touchdown of the game.
No need to give it to a fullback down here on the goal line with this team when they've got a halfback that can cram it in there like that.
New Orleans is up a score. Garcon takes it at the 40. At the 40, across midfield. Inside the 30, and he finds the open field. And he will score. What a return!
When you have a weapon like that returning kicks, sometimes the hardest thing is to just get the other team to kick in the ball. They always want to kick it away. Maybe he ought to limp on the field.
He'll return it from the 4-yard line. At the 30. They get him at the 37. The Saints were able to put a scoring drive together on their last timeout. Short throw to the right. Colston makes his third catch of the game. 2 yards away here on second down. Gets the pass away. Bush makes his third grab. They line up at the 45. Flips it out short. Drops the sure pick. Second down now following the incomplete pass. At the end of the first quarter, it's knotted up. They'll face second down and 10. Passes the ball. He leaves. It's caught. To the 10. The New Orleans Saints go 65 yards in 4 plays and cap it off with a touchdown.
Drew Brees is one of the top quarterbacks in the league, and there's really no debate about that. He can change the outcome of the game, and he's such a strong leader, just a fantastic player and fun to watch.
He'll take it from the 2. Brought down at the 29-yard line. The offense will take over at the 29-yard line. Steps up in the pocket. Throws it. Can't hang on. Darren Sharper was defending on the play. So they'll face a 2nd and 10.
Well, the defense didn't get the sack, but they got the next best thing, and that was a bad throw.
Gets the pass out. Makes the catch.
The Colts got a big play that time, and they need a whole lot more of that after beginning this game with a very pedestrian passing attack. That was good.
Here we go!
Moves forward. Throws it out. Bats it away. Gonzalez was the intended receiver. Steps up in the pocket. Comes down with it.
The Colts have been facing a pretty stiff pass defense so far. And they haven't been getting too much on their completions, but that time, a big play, and that's exactly what they needed.
hits the tailback. He gets to about the 31-yard line before he's wrestled to the ground.
We got to, boys!
They line up at the 31. Feeds it to the back. Charles Grant was there to bring him down.
As a quarterback, you really want to make that pre-snap read, and it's kind of hard to not see the middle linebacker. He came on the blitz that time, and sometimes you just need to get out of a play like that.
And they'll run him again. Tackle was made by McCray.
Joseph Addai is really the perfect back for this style of offense. Of course, they have the ability to spread the field with the passing game. You see a lot of nickel and dime coverage against this passing game. So now you're creating some rushing lanes for Joseph Addai, and he really takes advantage of it.
They're going to pitch it. Stays on his feet. No official signal yet. The call is not a touchdown. Offense comes out first and goal, needing a touchdown to tie things up. Throws it short. And the pass falls incomplete. And they can't complete the first down pass attempt. Second down coming up. Just gets it away. Touchdown, Colts.
Reggie Wayne has so many great skills. Great hand, great route runner. He can make the tough catch in traffic. What a valuable weapon he is.
The extra point to tie this game up. Adam Vinatieri adds the extra point. Here's a look at the drive summary presented by Sprint. Gathered at the 6. He breaks the tackle. The Saints ended their last drive with a touchdown, so they'll look to make it 2 in a row. Throws right. The stop was made by Bob Sanders. Shockey gains a handful of yards on that reception, so that'll make it second down. And he's hit as he let go of the ball.
When you get that kind of pressure, a lot of times the play will result in something worse than just an incompletion.
Gets the pass away. Jennings is there on the tackle. Moore makes his third grab. He gets popped as he throws.
And if he can get just a little bit more time, there are guys running open down the field. The pressure is getting close, but it's not there. He should take a fraction longer to make that throw.
Here's the pass. Henderson was the intended receiver on the play. Third and 10 coming up. Ball at their own 46. Throws it. Leaping catch. Tackle was made by Sanders. Marcus Colston now with 4 catches in the game. We'll hear from the referee for the first time in the game. There for the reception. And that flag was thrown in the area of holding.
Holding. Repeat, first down.
So the penalty puts him back for a first and long. Passes. Henderson can't make the catch. Devery Henderson was his intended target. Defense closing in.
You know, we talk about timing on offense all the time, but when you play against this defensive coordinator, he is going to consistently throw your offense off balance because of all the blitzes he's going to throw at him. You have to anticipate blitz on every snap when you play against this guy.
Still third down.
That penalty pushes them back even further, third and very long here on this play. Passes it out. Pass is complete.
Pretty good effort that time, but on third and very long, sometimes tough to pick up that first down.
This one's going to go out of bounds at the 20. The Colts will look to build momentum by getting another touchdown on this series. Here's the throw. The 50. Harper tackles him at the 43-yard line.
Peyton Manning is just the prototypical NFL quarterback, probably the surest bet week in and week out, a perennial Pro Bowler, arguably the best quarterback in the league. Not so much a bad pass as a bad decision. He saw the coverage there, simply had to go to the next receiver. He didn't make the right move.
Moves up. Throws it short. Shanley intercepts it. To the 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. Boy, the defense put the pressure on and forced the bad throw.
And throwing the football is really about what you do with your feet. The great ones can throw off balance and out of position. But so many guys, if they don't get their feet set, they make throws just like that, and it costs their team.
New Orleans will be kicking off. Garcon and Rushing stand deep awaiting the kickoff. They'll try a squib kick. The stop was made by Simonon.
Their last series was a downer, but this is a chance now to come back out and prove that you're not going to dwell on that. Just pick up a couple of first downs, and the last thing in the world they need right now, though, is a three and out.
Passes it, and it's completed. Harper is there on the tackle.
If you're going to try and stop a tight end from catching those types of balls, you have to get physical with him at the line of scrimmage. If you give him free releases, he's going to wear you out.
Under heavy pressure, Gade has it. And he's hammered at the 19-yard line.
You know, some of these corners are just freakish athletes right now. Oftentimes, they're the best athletes on the field. Maybe they don't have the skill set, great hands, great moves, whatever, but they are definitely among the fastest in the NFL.
Tackle was made by Wheeler. That's a gain of 8. That'll bring up second down. We'll take you to the studio now for halftime.
All right, Tom, thanks. Hopefully everyone enjoyed the first half. We'll get you straight to the highlights. Enjoy. there was a big discrepancy in the number of plays run by each team in the first half, and the edge was held by New Orleans. Breeze has thrown for over 175 yards. New Orleans leads it by 7. We'll get back to the game now. Enjoy the second half.
Welcome back to Indianapolis. Gets to about the 27. First and 10. Ball on their own 27. Tosses left. He's still going. Adai gains 8 yards on that play. Second and 2. Ball on their own 35. Is away, and he caught it. A stop was made by Gale.
Wayne makes his third catch of the game.
He'll get it again. He's hammered in the backfield.
Yeah, it really just throws you off rhythm to have a play that gains nothing. You know, you're usually going to get something, 2, 3, 4 yards, and it keeps you in that rhythm. But when a defense makes a play like that, it really throws your offense off.
Did he get there? We'll have a measurement. He did get enough for the first. First down now and 10 to go. Ball on the 14. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Cedric Ellis was there on the tackle. Adai gets about a yard in the play.
Man, oh man, that's what those defensive guys live for right there. A shot like that. And then they always get up and have a little something to say to you as you're going back to the huddle.
There for the catch. Dallas Clark with his third reception. Only 5 yards away from the goal line. Passes to the end zone. Harper bats it down. And the pass was knocked away at the last minute.
I don't know if that's the guy I want to pick on third down when you have to have a conversion. He is tough.
And with that, the score is the Indianapolis Colts 17, the Saints 21. Gets to the 31-yard line. The offense will take over at the 31. Makes the short throw. Breeze, second down for the offense after that incomplete pass. Short throw to the right. Marlon Jackson makes the tackle. Campbell caught that one for a gain of 6. That'll make it third down. He lays it out there. Deflected and broken up. The defender gets a hand on it, and that will bring up fourth down.
Well, at the end of the game, you go back and you basically say, what happened on third down? And you have a pretty good indication of how that game came out. Good play by the defense.
He makes it out to the 34-yard line.
The Colts were able to score on that last series, but just a field goal, and sometimes those are actually momentum shifters for the defense.
head as he let go of the ball.
Good pressure that time, and they forced a bad throw. Not much he could have done with the pocket collapsing like that.
On the ground with a tailback.
You know, listen, I would never want to block a defensive lineman. So, you know, I've seen these guys. I know these guys. They're big and they're nasty. But at least from an offensive standpoint, you have to try to get in their way.
Gets the pass off. Incomplete pass. Dallas Clark was the intended receiver. New Orleans looks like they're sending everything but the kitchen sink at this punt. Bush fields it at the 24. The 50. They get him at the 46-yard line. The offense takes the field, and we'll see if they can put something together after their last drive ended with a three and out. He can't bring him down. That's a gain of five. That brings up second down. Gets the ball away. Is there for the catch. Tackle is made by Jennings.
It really is so much the key to football. You talk all the time about you have to establish a run. Well, there you see why. You establish a run, and then you come with a play-action pass. Just so hard to defend.
Gets the pass away. Wheeler knocks it down.
Results.
They can't complete the pass. Now the offense will be looking at second down.
Second down.
Dumps it out right. The stop was made by Robert Mathis. Colston makes it five catches for the game. Passes the ball. Brings it in. Moore with his fourth catch of the game. And that's the end of the third quarter. Score is 21-17. Saints. The Saints start the final quarter with the lead and the ball in the red zone. They hand it off.
You gotta love this guy. I had a chance to talk to him in the offseason, and the one thing that he said that drives him nuts about any running back are guys that run out of bounds. He wants to lower his head, create contact, and crush anybody in his path.
Extra point is good. Let's take a look at the sprint drive summary. Taken at the 5. Hit and dropped at the 31. They didn't look sharp on their last drive and were forced to punt it away. Got it off barely.
Pass rush almost got there that time, and he has to feel a little lucky that that ball just fell harmlessly to the turf.
Passes to his left. Tackle is made by Will Smith. A dive on that one for a gain of 6. That'll make it third down. Throws it. He's there for the catch. And this receiver just loves it when the defense is in man cover.
Yeah, there's no better feeling than when you're coming off the ball and you know it's just you and the guy across from you. That's just good old-fashioned football. But you also know typically when you get man coverage, your quarterback is under pressure.
Manning will hand it off. The stop was made by Clancy. 6-yard pickup, and that will bring up second down. gets the pass out. He goes up high for the catch.
And there you see just a little bit of how tremendous these athletes are in the NFL. The ability to go up above the defense and make a play like that, that was fun to watch.
I like it, baby.
From the
16-yard
line. Gets out to about the 15-yard line before he's gang tackled from the 15-yard line. They hand it off. Gains his way to the 7-yard line before he's hit and dropped. Brush as he threw. Not sure what the call is. Let's see what the flag is all about. First and goal, and the offense needs a touchdown to get back into this game. Just gets that one away.
Just missed that time, bringing him down for a sack. The great pressure to force an incompletion.
He throws right. Knocked down. He can't hook up on the pass. Now the offense will be facing third down. Gets another handoff.
What a run that was. He was trapped behind the line of scrimmage. It looked like he was going to go down for a big loss. Instead, he breaks the tackle and runs it in for the touchdown.
They hand it off. Great job there. They were able to convert.
And you could tell the offense had a plan throughout that drive. Not only did they get the touchdown, but they immediately got the call in for the two-point conversion. They knew exactly what they wanted to do and executed it perfectly.
Here's your sprint drive summary. He makes it out to the 30-yard line. Gets to the back. Bush fumbles it. They'll pile up for it. Bethea gets his hand on it and scoops it up.
What a big turnover that is. Just about the time you think this offense is going to take control of the football game, they pump it up, and oh my goodness, we have ourselves a ball game now.
They'll give it off here. The tackle was made by Smith. A dive gets about 4 yards on the play. As he lets it go.
The Saints weren't going to go the entire game without that guy catching at least one ball. But so far, they've done a pretty good job of containing him here today.
Let's go to work, y'all. Let's go to work.
First and goal. We have 2 minutes left to play in this game. Steps up in the pocket. And the pass is incomplete. That incompletion will bring up second down. A dive off the right side. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. Charles Grant was there on the tackle. to him just as he released it.
Now, it's not a horrible call in that situation because you put the ball in the hands of a playmaker. You try and allow him to create, but you're seeing now defensively when they close together like that, it's going to be awfully tough to pick up that first down.
So, it's fourth down. This will be a 26-yard field goal attempt. He's got it. Here's a look at the drive summary presented by Sprint. Fielded at the 9. At the 40. Drop at the 45.
The Saints have some time to work with here, but you've got to be careful about being too aggressive. You certainly don't want to turn it over and make it easy on the other team.
Dumps it out left. He catches it and is tackled immediately. Devery Henderson with his third reception. Hit as he throws. He thinks he hauled it in, but we'll see what the officials say. They're not going to give it to him.
Good try. That was a really good try, but let's give the officials credit. They got it right.
Throws it short. Jennings makes the tackle.
The Colts did an excellent job tackling and keeping things in front of them on that series to force the three and out.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Colts will begin this drive at the 20. Manning hands it off straight ahead. Grant is there on the tackle. First and 10. Throws the deep pass. Bats it away. Harper had the coverage on the play.
Second down.
Short pass to his left. Colley makes his third catch of the game. He throws short. Hit as he caught it, and he's able to hang on. Clark makes it 5 catches for the game. Passes to his left. Darren Sharpert was there to bring him down.
The Colts are having some success getting the ball down the field on this drive. This offense is clicking.
Moves to his right. Gets hit, and it's intercepted. Well, that's the end of regulation, and this game is unsettled, so we're going to overtime. From the 7, he stopped at the 24-yard line. They line up at the 24. He throws right. Makes the catch. And he's crossed the century mark in receiving yards. This has been one heck of a performance.
And Tom, I don't think he's finished yet. This is a guy that is on a roll right now, and this defense really doesn't have an answer for him.
Throws it out. Henderson can't make the catch. Third down coming up after that incomplete pass. Third down. Dumps it out right. Comes down with it. Shockey with his third reception. They line up at the 43. Bush gets the ball. Bush picks up about 7 yards on the run. They'll need about 3 yards here on second down. He may not have gotten there. They'll measure. Yes, he got there.
The offense probably trying to build a little momentum there. Instead of taking their shot at the big play, decided to play it conservatively and just convert.
They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Marlon Jackson is there on the tackle.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action and there's almost no way to stop an offense. If you can't stop the run, and you have to deal with play action.
He needs to get rid of it. Excellent pass protection. Makes the grab. No signal yet. We'll see what they rule. So after conferring, they're going to say he was out of bounds.
Good try. That was a really good try, but let's give the officials credit. They got it right.
And they'll run him again. He's dropped for a loss.
And I really like the discipline of this defense. You never see these guys trying to do too much. They control their gaps, and that time, there was nowhere to go.
There for the reception. Tackle was made by Freeney.
Well, when you have a talented running back like this, you always have to account for him. That time, a nice play-action pass opened it up down the field.
First down now and 10 to go. Ball on the 18. Off the upright and good.
Let's take a look at the sprint drive summary.
That's all from Lucas Oil Stadium. Highlights are next, so stay right.